High return there, wasn't it, from Shushin? Nicely put away by Francisco.
We saw the defense off the black side of the racket on the backhand. Shushin here, a little bit of a fishing attempt instead of turning the racket around.
It was interesting what you were saying there, that he's got a decent record against Fan Zhongdong, Francisco.
It's all relative.
Well, decent. He's got some wins.
He has beaten him once, and that is more than most of the world outside of China can say.
Well, that's interesting, because that head-to-head against his opponent today, Shushin, he's played them 10 times and never won.
Well, that's why it was so exciting when he had match point, just to watch and wonder. But Shushin, always the coolest guy in the room, still controlled his nerves.
Yeah, that's the closest he's ever got, Francisco. That was at the Australian Open, as you mentioned, in 2019.
You know,
4-3.
Right. Dima and Ma Long had a similar situation at the Olympic Games. Nice redirection here. Down the line, turns the racket to get a little bit of the side of the ball. Now, Shushin has a deadly forehand, a very long stroke, varying spins. That penhold grip gives him a lot of versatility and flexibility in the wrist. But Franziska's doing an excellent job of setting up that third ball right now, and it's tough to keep it short when you're starting from so far away.
That started with a great bit of reaction there from Franziska.
Now, this is a best of five, so unlike the last time they played, the chance for an upset always that much greater in a shorter span.
He's playing really well at the moment, isn't he, Francisco?
Yeah, he's done everything right here, from the touch play to the placement on the table. As soon as he's got Shushin deep in the backhand corner, it creates an opening. Good counter here. What a snap back there. That first backhand from Shushin would end the point against most players. Racket high for Franziska and up by four.
Yeah, it's placed that well after the readjustment from Shushin.
In all fairness, that was still an incredibly good recovery from Shushin. Franziska, look at him wiggle there to watch it. And that ball inside the table played it down the line.
This is a great run of points from Francisco.
He's not missing anything. There was a net ball in there, and he recovered it with an attack, with a full-on loop. Watch this. That's the one. Clips the net, stays low, and still he plays it perfectly at the baseline on the parallel.
Well, Shushin, desperate to try and break that run of points. Good crowd has come in tonight.
Yeah, it seems that the crowd size is, that's the effect that Shushin has. He brings in the spectators.
Nine,
second to
three.
Last shot there, clipping a little bit off the top of the net.
Still a lot of work to do for Shushin. In some trouble here, because Francisco has six game points. Shushin has to dig deep if he wants to save this game. Very deep.
5-10.
Good use of side spin to go with the top spin on that shot. Again, that long stroke. Shushin taking it later than most of his teammates.
2 points saved.
10-6.
Shushin has had his share of comebacks over the years, from games to match points.
He's done well here, Patrick Francisco. And taking that first game, 11-6.
Incredible to watch, really fascinating. Mm.
One love.
So I'll be curious if I'll see those Singaporeans in Paris. I feel like the longevity, the lifespan of the athletes, there were some players in their 40s and 50s competing at a high level. Although Ni Xiaolian here at 58, I mean, a bit of an anomaly. Also a standing player doing quite well, top 40 in the world.
Four. One, two.
Good play from Francisca, cramping him up for space there.
Yeah, good timing right off the bounce. You'll see this here, follows his serve. So pendulum serve, just drifted long. Has to stay way forward on the first one, racket high for the second to take it early.
Ooh. He is just playing superbly at the moment, isn't he, the German?
Yeah, this forehand down the line to play that on the parallel. Shushin loves to turn that corner, and Patrick Franziska is going to make him second guess that. He doesn't show where he's going to go. Franz keeps it very well disguised.
This is all going his way at the moment, Francisco.
TTK Bank, Table Tennis Karma Bank.
4-3.
Still leading, though. It's just not going his way at the moment, Shushin.
Franziska is being very specific in his serves. I mean, that serve looked like top and side spin, and it was short. He's making it such a difficult day for Shushin.
That's a bit more like it, isn't it? Third ball attack. Nicely done. Shushin.
Pendulum serve a bit on the shorter side here. Franziska playing it from deep on the table passively. He'll look to get in where he can.
Net for five.
Wouldn't be the first time that an umpire has seen it and the players didn't.
Didn't, yep.
Net for five.
But this time it's the opposite.
Another good point here for Francisca. Moves two ahead of Shushin.
Yeah, moves in, plays that softly well. Two touch shots in a row, and then the one opening backhand on the parallels enough. Tighter game than game one by quite a bit.
Going for his shots, isn't he, Francisca?
Absolutely, and Shushin doing a good job here to put more spin on this ball. Keeps it inside the table, forcing Franz to move in and play it from over the table.
He's drawn level.
6-0.
It's got to be very difficult. I raise my hand in tournaments when something like that happens.
And for the first time, he has taken the lead here, Shushin. And he power on from here.
It's a good streak. And he's had his comeback streaks over the years. Lin Gaoyuan for one, but he's taken matches back from many. Jun
Mizutani. Meat and drink, isn't it?
Meat and drink?
Oh, is this a new one?
Is it British English?
It's English.
I know the word drink, I know the word meat. I know two definitions for meat, actually.
This is standard stuff for him. How about that? Is that probably the closest way?
Oh, maybe like meat and potatoes for us?
Oh, yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good one.
Liquefied potato drink. I'm loving it.
9-6 now, Shushin.
Maybe later they'll meet and drink.
Maybe.
9.
Oh, there's a furrowed brow there.
That was the exact phrase that I was going to use. He's so insightful and so inquisitive. So every once in a while, I mean, he wears his heart on his sleeve.
Is he, for you, one of the interesting characters out there in table tennis, Shushin?
One of the most. I mean, he's an incredible player, as he's got three game points here to tie it up. There's just so much to talk about. I'll save it.
Saves one, Francisca.
8-10.
But he's all over the highlight reels.
Lovely way to win that second game and level things up.
like a reverse Penhold forehand, using the backhand side of the racket on his forehand.
And that's what...
Wingspan here from Franziska after this, watch this. Covers the middle, Shushin goes right to the line.
Look how far back he is. The groans and the oohs and ahs from the crowd.
And in all fairness, this is just a taste of what Shushin brings to the game. I mean, we've seen him win points back here like nobody's business so many times. Sky lobs, he can counter with both sides of the racket. There he's using the black side, the forehand. But he's done swooping shots that curve around the net, forehand, backhand, it doesn't matter. That's why we call him Superman. He's capable of anything.
Brilliant, brilliant from Franziska.
Lock three.
This is the serious power that it just amazes me that the balls don't crack on contact when Franz hits it this hard. Shushin doesn't blink though. He doesn't flinch. He just holds the racket up. He probably blinked, but that's about it.
Kind of knew what was happening next, didn't he?
Well, he took his chances.
Was that a bit of distraction there, perhaps?
I think he said, sorry, too loud speaking. You've got VIP seats. We don't want to have to hear what your schedule is for later.
Back just edge. On the edge. Everything far going off. His way.
Chop block there from Shushin. He's taking his chances. You know, even when he's missing his shots, he's taking the right shots. He's playing out of his comfort zone.
A terrific start again in this game three for Franziska. Shushin not used to this against this particular opponent, one he's dominated over the years. He is struggling here.
Shushin changes his short game a bit. And he is the first to get the attack here. The touch play right in off the bounce. A little bit quicker to get in.
First point he has gotten this game. He finally runs, stops that run. Two in a row. Can he continue this?
It would be conservative, but it might be necessary. If Shushin wins this point, I wouldn't be surprised to see a timeout.
Let's see if he makes that move. Oh, ooh, it looked like he was for a second.
Turn back to look just to check in. I mean, this is the type of momentum, three quick points. They weren't after counter loop exchange.
That's brilliant from Shushin now.
Four, six.
Looking back again.
I think now that's the sound of a timeout. If not now, then when? Four in a row for Shushin, but the way he's won them, it just seems like he's disassembled his opponent. He's got Franziska.
Five.
Well, this is a very, very good comeback. Can he complete it now and level the score, Shushin? Brilliant stuff from Shushin.
Tough to receive.
You know what? You call this a boxing match. Seven. That's got to be a bit of a sucker punch because you've been leading. You've been dominating this, and out of nowhere, now you're trailing.
Just goes to show you that between having fast legs, keeping the gloves up, and looking for opportunities to get the jabs in,
six, seven.
Where there's a will, there's a way.
You said Shushin has been in tougher scenarios and come out of it, and the frustration now telling on the German paddler.
I mean, I've been watching the German league for quite some time, and I can't recall, maybe in a league match, but on the world tour and around the world, I can't recall seeing that or hearing that much frustration from Franz. He knows he had an incredible start to this game, and it slipped. or maybe I should say taken away. Not for lack of intention on the other side for the man in blue, MIB.
Well, he's absolutely desperate to break that run, and he finally did it after 8 consecutive points from Su Xin. Eight all. More twists in the tail.
Yes, yes. This gets very interesting for me. With great anticipation. I mean, the changes out here, because Franz is in position well enough. It's not a perfect setup, but he's where he needs to be. You can see Qin Zhijian in the background gives 2 thumbs up. Go for your shots, Su Xin. That's what those thumbs up were. When you miss a shot, that's okay.
Did they get an edge? Bit of a debate about that.
Well, he said 100%. Let's see this again. Yep, yep, no question, absolutely. 100%.
Absolutely, he is right.
That's
I guess Su Xin didn't see it himself. That's why he was questioning it.
Yeah, interesting.
Fair enough.
I didn't. I think I turned to look at you for a moment.
Oh, let's turn this around now to have game points.
And, but I mean, how many times have we been sure of something only to find out we were wrong?
Correct.
Not this time. 2 game points for France.
Saved one. This is nothing, is it? 2-point deficit, game points. That's nothing for Su Xin after what we've just seen earlier.
It's cheese and butter. Is that, that's not a British?
No, but okay. We could make it.
Fish and pizza.
He's done it. Francisco has won 2 now. 11-9.
And in a best of 5, that puts him in a very interesting position now, 1 game away.
So will he come back with a vengeance here, Su Xin?
Well, he came out with a strong backhand down the line. We haven't seen too many of these. I think that's a good sign for Su Xin that he's going to be trusting his backhand more.
Not cool.
Good placement on that to the shorter side of the table. Franz was expecting it cross court.
Great serve.
1-2.
Comes off a little funny, and you wonder, is there a particle of rubber from the edge of my racket? Something that affected the bounce to change it?
So some debris that it might have just hit.
It happens. I had a match recently where the ball, you couldn't hear it bounce, and both me and the player at the same time went, what? And I still managed to play the shot, but it was completely distracting.
This is the best start he has had so far. Looked a little bit annoyed there, Francisca.
As he would, he doesn't want Su Xin to get any confidence or momentum here.
Come on.
Now with that long forehand.
Up by 3.
Starting to cash in a little bit of those few of those IOUs, maybe just 1. Still has a few more to go from the start.
6-4.
So there's something in common with you and Patrick Francisca.
Yeah, a lot. But I want to hear what you have to say.
You're both big. Well, come back to
That's it. You're just both big. Thank you.
Both big shoe collectors into sneakers.
Interesting.
Says he's obsessed with it. I'm not sure you're obsessed with that, are you?
Talk about it on a towel break. Ooh.
4-8.
Big lead here for Su Xin.
It's funny, I think Franziska and I, Franz, have a lot in common, but Su Xin and I probably more.
3-8.
Su Xin and I have a lot in common. Obviously, his level is one of the best in the world and sets him apart from most.
This is what was coming, didn't he? Again, he's just pointing at the table.
I will say that every arena has differences from tables to balls. Things are changing. It's not the exact same one every time. And a timeout now on Shuxin's side. So a three-point lead back from his timeout. Shuxin, after a talk with Qin Zhijian, a plan and a second serve.
Ooh. Oh, again, another edge.
It's 6-8.
Well, that's a withering look.
The IOUs are stacking up here for Shuxin. But fortune favoring the bold, Franziska has been very clear on his tactics.
That's a great return from Shuxin.
Nine.
A big long stroke forehand here, and this time it's the bigger man, Patrick Franziska, who's dealing with the heat coming back. Look at that bend with interest.
Nine.
That is unlucky.
Well, it's very good placement. Patrick Franziska, that ball would have hit Shuxin probably right in the Li Ning sign over his right chest. I know he only has one chest, but the right half of it. He really had to move the upper body there. Still a two-point lead.
Look at that placement.
Nine.
Well eight. Away from Shuxin, and only a point behind now.
For the Cloud Walker, there are very few places he cannot get a racket on the ball. It had to be this sharp. Side spin as well. Just cradling the ball and sending it off abroad.
A little bit of pressure here now, Shuxin.
It's an understatement.
Further and further back. He's just 2 points away, Franziska. He's almost there. Well, that might be the biggest shot of the night from the crowd. Game point for Shuxin.
And from Shuxin. Haven't heard too much from him.
He's done it. Shuxin has come back to win this game. 2-2. Came within points, just a couple of points to win that.
Right, the narrowest gap there is, 2 points in the decider.
And it's going to come down to a decider here.
Hits him in the shirt. Fair play. Blitzes the table. Punches down. I love that Shuxin says, yep. A little bit of a wry smile, points to the umpire, says, yeah, hit me in the shirt. Points Patrick's.
One all.
We'll have a look at that previous point where it hit his shirt.
Well played. Good sportsmanship there. It's just so touching. You know, dignity can win a point, but dignity. That's a lifetime of work.
2-1.
Integrity.
Integrity, yep, that's the word.
There's a video on YouTube that just brings tears to the eyes every time. If you type in table tennis integrity, it involved Wang Liqin, one of the greats from the good early 2000 era. Now, this was very smart play from Franz. He goes safely cross-court again, knowing that Shuxin would want to cover the wide forehand. He starts to move back and has to try and backpedal there.
What was the hand up there? Because I didn't see it hit a net.
Sometimes it catches the edge of the racket, which changes the sound of the contact, making it a little tough to know exactly what's on it. I don't know if that's exactly what happened, but that can be the case, often is. This backhand, as clean as can be. Franz with a 1 point lead here, second serve. But we're far, far from over.
Three, four.
It's a very difficult ball to control. Loaded with spin, left in front of Franziska. Smart play again. Shushin not too proud to slow it down from time to time.
Drawn level.
And these are two similar points. I mean, he's investing in the slow topspin. And it's all relative. There's still low trajectory on it, but it is loaded with spin, and it's not a kill shot. This is where the in and out of table tennis is so important. If someone leaves it low in front of you and spinny. I like it. It's almost slow motion, that sort of phantom spin after the rally. It's with the forehand.
Big roar again from the crowd. Shushin draws level. Coach is on his feet.
Understandable. This is a really testing rally here, a test of nerves. When the ball gets open like this in the counter loop exchange, Franz gets one back deep to the corner, touching ground. Shushin gets that right hand on the ground after getting low for that counter. And think about where he hit that from. I mean, he was way off on the backhand side.
Yeah. Put the height on that one, didn't he?
Shot.
Easy for Franziska.
Yeah, Franziska set this up with the shot before by playing it half long and catches Shushin in between. That's where he plays a defensive shot from the baseline and that sort of loose neck look is, man, I know I can't be playing passively from there.
They're just trading points at the moment. They're battling for each one. I just wonder whether Australian Open is coming back.
For whom?
Well, for either one. I would have thought Franziska, the back of his mind, I was so close. Is this going to come back to haunt me again? It's on the floor. That is the rally of the day.
Unfreaking believable. Shushin with the big steps of Franziska on the other side takes the legs out of him. He runs them around, touches ground there, wide once again. Shushin the complete opposite side of the court and the reverse pendulum backhand for the win. Racket goes flying. Franz catches it, but you can understand the frustration. Look at the work for this. How do you even get back up? Qin Zhijian there. He was the only one staying in frame for the camera. And it's a 2-point lead for the Cloud Walker with the serves on his side.
He's pulled one back there, Franziska, but that was superb entertainment.
The funny thing is, we usually see Shushin doing most of the chasing. He's the Cloud Walker after all. But he's running around Franz. Big point there for Franz. On the receive, one big one to go now.
Two on the serve.
8-4.
From Shushin, that's excellent for Franziska, and he gets a serve now. Where is this going?
It doesn't matter. The fact is we're here. That's what matters. You know who I feel bad for? Anyone who didn't know to watch this live. No warning to play. Doesn't miss by a lot. Good pressure from Franz. That's 3 points in a row from down 6-8.
Very good.
Whether he's thinking about Australia 2019 or not, the score lines are shaping up to be quite similar for a best of five.
Two away, Franziska.
Ooh. Shushin says let, hits the net. Okay, I love it.
Explain that one to us.
That is credit. This is that Shushin is such a good guy that he would never do something unfair, faintly touches the net. I mean, that is barely.
Wow.
That is so barely. Hawk eyes, and Franz says, okay. I mean, Franz just made an incredible, ridiculous shot that would have set him up with two match points, but the credit with Shushin is so good, he said, okay.
Well, he does get his match point. One point save for Shushin.
I think I outgrew asthma about 20 years ago, but I think I might have it again. You have an inhaler? I was just going to ask. That's so funny. 9 serving 10, second match point.
He's done it! Francis Franziska has finally broken that jinx. 10 matches before. He's never beaten this opponent. Look at that. What it means to him. He goes up to Shushin, and he has finally done it on attempt number 11.